1400 meters better. Still looking fine though. If I can use this to get about 5 tons into orbit and actually be able to land this again, probably not on a runway, but just land it so it don't destroy it, I think it would be. It's about 1900 meters, that's where. Well, the game alter it. Wonder if I'm gonna stay here. Am I going to accelerate? I am accelerating. Now I'm going down. Okay, that I think the other approach we did was better. Just keep the incline on 10 degrees, and then when you get to like. Let's go, let's accelerate some more. Oh, right. Oh, crap. I forgot. Okay, at least it didn't. I need to drop the other ones before I start the one. That wasn't beautiful, that's for sure.
That's for sure.
Let's see if we can't. If we can, we should be able. At like about 650. Just needed to circularize, then we have like 500 meters left. So we should be able to, plus we have a little bit extra in the monopropellant. Should be able to put something in like 100 meters. Might be the reason why I went away from that. I don't think it has any. Why is this so hard? Because it's trying to simulate real life. Oh. I knew that. So what if go off of the air spike on that one, and then go, don't want a big one. But I need something with gimbal. And this has like 345 ISP in a vacuum. That one is actually really, really effective. But I'm not sure if you're gonna give us not enough oomph. Okay, they only have like five more, but we, this one, if I remember correctly, gimbals, doesn't it? Yeah, it gimbals 4%. And this one gimbals. So it actually gimbals less. And it's a little bit less. Uses a little more. This is only half a ton. Well, what the heck? Let's try it. Right? What's the worst that's gonna happen? So if I go, and it actually needs to go alone, check your staging. So, if I go, one is the Rapier engine, or the Ram engine, sorry. And then two is the Aerospike, and then three, instead of the Poof, we go Terrier, Toggle, then four is Poof. Toggle engine, and toggle engine. It's getting a little elaborate now. Maybe this should just go full ham. Because then we can turn the aerospikes, and we can turn the solid booster that gives us a little bit extra speed. And then we can... I think the problem I'm doing is I'm pitching up too much when I want to go into space. Because when I do that, I'm kind of slowing the plane down, because I'm showing more of my belly of the plane, which creates this massive massive drag, but it also gives us lift. So I'm not sure which one I should go for. But I think if the plane didn't flip, we had enough to go into orbit. So I kind of want to see if I can't find something else that weighs maybe a ton. That's half a ton. That's way more than a half a ton. Don't we have anything that weighs about a ton? Oh, can't decide. This empty one was kind of cool. Maybe we should keep it at that. Oh, hey, yo, 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 yo. Mr. Butterfinger. Let's put 30 in, how much that? So, where's the ton? There. 7, 8, 5, 5. Let's try and put in a ton of 70. Oh, that goes fast. It's about there. What's that? 90. Let's put another 90. Now I think we have some dead weight. Wow. Just a second. I'm too tired to do math in my head. So, 76. No. Oh, stupid. 76.554, I think it was. Yes, let's put this in. Eighty-two, 154. 82, 154. A 5.6 ton. I think that's gonna be a max. That's right. Try and keep this pitch. Not really sure where, not where, more when we can, you know, let go of the Rapier engines. Not let go. Oh. And I meant the Ram engine. When are they gonna set out? Is that like 25 kilometers or? I think I need to look at the number down here. When the speed is going down, that's when we are, we're supposed to accelerate. Because when I activated the other engines this time, it felt like I felt like I had to do it. That where I was only about like 500 minus 500 meters, not 500,000 meters. In periapsis height, and like last time, before, the turn before that was closer. It's not easy.
It's not easy being green.
As the Kerbal say. But if I remember the ramjet engines correctly, it's kind of like, you know, the higher up in the atmosphere you're coming, the thinner the air is gonna be, but also the less resistant there is, and the faster you can go, so you can ram more air into the engines, because you're flying faster. That's kind of the idea of the ram jet engine. You kind of ram the air into the jet engine. About Mach 2. I'm really sure time warp to the sun up instead of flying in the dark. At least the plane is light up or lit up by the orangey red. Overheating of the plane. A 1,000 meters per second. Not bad. Slowing down. The acceleration is slowing down. Okay, stuff is going down, so let's accelerate with these. Keep an eye on when that acceleration is going down. Kingston is still, you know, pitching up. Okay, we barely have enough to accelerate. Nice. I don't know if that number actually holds us. 6,000 meters per second. Yeah, let's just turn it off, the ram engines. 1,300 meters per second, that's probably not enough. The acceleration is, it's only 7,000 meters per second. Or is it? Oh, it's 8 point. It's in 3 digits. Only 8 meters per second, but we're still going. With the periapsis. Apoapsis is still going up. So we should be fine.
Fine.
But I think it's going to be close. I'm trying to pitch down now, so the we are maybe going to catch up with the time to apparatus. I don't really want to get a minute over the periapsis. Doesn't really. I don't think the gimbal on the engine here is not strong enough to actually pitch the nose of the plane down. You know, catching too much air. Let's see if I put on the RCS. Is that gonna help? It does. Going down. I think we have to cut the engines here. That's because I kind of want to get closer. The closer you are to apoapsis, the less energy you're gonna use to get to that point. So now we're kind of thrown the periapsis out in front of us. So we're not really when you're closer, you're pushing to the apoapsis, the more energy you're transferring directly into raising the periapsis. So if you're burning here, you kind of pushing it over here somewhere instead of exactly on the spot. That's not fuel efficient. I should have turned on the RCS a little before that. But it seems like this is going to be possible. Because I can turn off two now. Because I don't think I need them. I have to wait and see. Because we're almost in space, and then we can push zero. Get some solar panels out. Be ready for that, because how much power do we still have? Not a lot, so that's a good idea. Let's turn off the RCS, because we do have a reaction wheel, so we should be able to control stuff. And let's try and circleize. 250. You know, it's close. We're going to use a little bit of the monopropellant in the end. I mean, it's because we're running out of oxidizer. We actually have a decent amount of liquid fuel left. Which is surprising, actually. Is it 4? Let's use some of the monopropellant too. Yeah, 5 ton is definitely the max. So if the first thing we set in orbit okay, got into orbit. Not a lot of monopropellant left, and definitely not a lot of fuel. Now that I didn't really... Oh, crap. I didn't really have a... if we got rid of these, this number will change a whole lot. Because now, then we have like 5 tons less mass to carry around. But I can see we can definitely put another. I think that these two are empty for oxidizer. I think we can put those oxidizers on again with no problem. So let's put in some way of us being able to either empty these or... Can you empty ore with the vent port? Because then I kind of want to try and let these go and then deorbit and see if I can land this in the next test. 5 ton, 5.6 ton, it seems fair. Let's put oxidize in these again. And then we need it. Couple of decouplers. Well, actually, let's just do one decoupler. Decouplers. Then we should probably. Wondering, because the reaction reel here is close to the center of mass. I believe that's the right thing to do, right? Okay, I thought I... Let's just build it in. Should probably strut these. So 1.6 ton to orbit. And I kind of have to, that's also the thing with these space planes. You kind of have to do it a little more manually. I'm not against that at all. It makes it a little harder, you know, when you are as bad as me. It would be nice if it was easier. Just telling. So let's try and... Oh, it accelerates. Better this time. I didn't land on the actual landing field. Okay. Let's wait another 5 minutes. I must admit, I know the waiting time is long and it's probably boring for you, and I'm sorry about that. But it's actually, for me, it's kind of exciting because I'm building this thing, and it exactly kind of satisfying seeing it's working. I don't believe I've built anything like this myself that's actually working as a concept, which is kind of cool. But yeah, definitely. Definitely cool. I'm actually sitting and thinking about if we, there's a lot of different biomes on Kerbin, and we could actually build like a big plane. I don't think we have the big plane parts, but we have like a big plane with all the science equipment and a lab. And then just fly to different biomes, get all the science, put it in the lab, let the lab technician run it, fly to the next point, land, do the science, and keep repeating. I think I'm playing normal, so we don't get like the highest number of science that we can get. But actually, I think we can do within the Kerbal. Kerbin sphere of influence, so Kerbin, Mon, and Minmus. I think we can do all the science there and do the whole tech tree. We don't need to go to Duna or one of the other planets. I kind of want to do that. Now I kind of want to do, you know, a small mission here, building like a, I don't know, a big communications array that's being flown up in parts and then put together in space somehow, and then that may be able to go into a highly eccentric orbit or something like that. Yeah, no thanks. Yeah. No. If I wanted to be Twitch playthrough sensation, I would rather have my followers to be real people and not bots. I'm not actually accelerating right now. Why am I not accelerating? I actually don't know. Okay, I do accelerate a little bit. Did that happen last time? I feel like weren't we? We're actually also going down now. What is going on here? We're losing altitude. Oh, what's going on here? I do have a pitch about 10, but I'm actually... just didn't notice. I feel like I've lost a lot of fuel. Did I forget to pick up the wheels? No. Was that just the extra oxidizer that made it that heavier? Well, it was 440 oxidizer. I feel like the speed should be higher now. Compared to the height we're flying, it should be higher, right? I think we're getting into space with this try here. And now we're getting a steady acceleration. Well, the other one was also a steady acceleration, but it was like 0.1 meters per second every other kilometer. Got an acceleration now on 13 meters per second. But I fear I've used too much fuel now. We've almost flown halfway around the actually we're not, we're only in the middle of the Kerbin Ocean. Acceleration is falling now. My speed is still going up, but the acceleration is falling. We need to keep an eye on that and then start engines number 2. Slowing down 9:42, 43, 44, slowing real much down, and 9:50. Can we get 9:50? We can, and then we turn the other ones on. Let's erase the pitch a little bit. Okay, we're decelerating. Acceleration is still falling. I think in about 5 or 10 seconds we're losing the ram engine. They're out. Let's turn them off. 1200 meters. I don't think we're going to be able to go into the... This time we have... maybe we don't. Still accelerating. We're not catching up. Oh, we are catching up on the apoapsis. That's okay. And I think we are now going up. Yes. Let's pitch down one. Don't think we're going to get into orbit this time. I think maybe we had too much oxidizer. Running out. Would I? I'm not losing speed if I do this. We are catching up with the apoapsis though. Because I think these are more efficient. It's a tiny bit more efficient. Now we have a surplus on the oxidizer. That's weird. We're not going into space. Not this time. Wonder what went wrong. I don't think. Let's give it a last try. It's gonna take like 10 minutes or so. How much weight is this? 84394. So that's like 2 ton something. So let's go like half. Halfsies. I think that's maybe a good way of doing it. Let's give it one more go. And hopefully that would be it. Zero, let's go. Five pitch, maybe. Zero roll. Mean to do that. I needed to turn off the brake, not lower the landing leg. Maybe I should just redo that. I already wasted a lot of fuel. Oh. Okay. Don't fold the landing engines. Surface, zero, plus. And no roll, execute, release brake. little bit of help here. Oops. I spaced a little too fast, maybe. So let's get up to like Mark 1 and then pitch up a little bit. Go to Mark 2 and then pitch up a little bit. That'd be a plan, maybe. Maybe just pitch up slowly, but keep the acceleration. Can we do that? Kind of cool. We have an acceleration of 13 right now. Is falling. Is that because of the pitch? It's too high, so let's put it down again. It's still falling. It shouldn't be falling. It's still falling. Why are you falling? It doesn't make sense. The aircraft should be getting lighter. So you should have easy, it should be an easier job for you to accelerate. I'm actually losing speed. I'm actually not sure what's going on. Pitch and raw and roll control down here is dead on. Let's raise the pitch a little bit here and then get out of the thickest part of the atmosphere. Maybe that's why we are decelerating. The mass of the vehicle is going down quick, so it shouldn't go down in meters per second square. Just shouldn't. Okay, we are now, I think, officially in a less thick part of the atmosphere. So we should start seeing the number go up, but we don't. Going down fast again. Why? I really don't understand. Should have plenty of air openings on this plane to actually ram enough air into the engine. See this thing just accelerate. about 12 kilometers. And the aircraft is almost 10 ton lighter now. To 10,000 meters per second. Okay, now we are at 10 meters per second square again. Remember what was the maximum thrust in this engine? I can't remember. Okay, let's accelerate. 11. Seconds. 13. 14. 15. Okay, 15. 15, 10. 20. Not bad. Keep the acceleration. Okay, the acceleration is going down now. Meters per second in speed. That's not bad. We have 7 seconds to apoapsis. In a sec here, we need to accelerate with second engines, and then we pitch up. I wonder if this thing can fly Mach 4. That would be like, what, 1200 and something? What is our orbital speed is 1300 kilometers. 1500 meters per second. Can't remember what we had before. I actually think it was about the same. We are again going to have a lot of oxidizer left. But we can't use oxidizer for anything. That's the irritating part. The liquid fuel we can use for the ramjets when we actually get down through the atmosphere, if ever. I have 27 seconds to apoapsis. I think we can go down to 10% pitch. Now it's rising again. So let's go down to 7. Don't know how much fuel we're actually losing for the drag of the plane. Yeah, let's just keep it there till we hit 70,000. Don't think we have enough fuel to circularize, but we only have like 500 oxidizer too much now. Which is kind of weird because we had like almost 1,000 liquid fuel before we put the oxidizer in. Maybe we should just lose the oxidizer. Oh crap. No, never mind. Okay, we're actually losing a decent amount to drag, which is kind of weird. I thought that plane was more aerodynamic. That's not gonna be this time. We're gonna try and land. We definitely need to take the It's not registering the ore. Almost reached periapsis. We can definitely get to orbit with this one. Stop. Then circularize. Not yet. Why can't I see the amount of ore? I wonder if it's I accidentally decoupled it. Maybe I need to do it with a docking instead, just so I don't detach it if I don't want to. Yeah. I don't know. Can I?
get rid of it. Didn't help with the amount of monopropellant. What? It's telling me that I don't have enough, but it's showing me up here I have enough, which is kind of weird. It doesn't really matter. We can't make it. I think, guys, sorry, we're going to end the stream here. And thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you have enjoyed yourself. That's what I'm trying to say. Because I've enjoyed myself. And thank you so much, guys, for taking like 2 hours out of my misery. No. I did manage to not forget that work sucks right now, but at least I didn't think about it. So that's a plus. Yeah. Yeah. If you liked what you see, please, if you're not already, consider giving the channel a follow so you don't miss next time I'm streaming. I do have a straw poll right now. Let me see if I can find the straw poll. Oh, it's actually linked in the description here. And it ends on Sunday. It's a straw poll about what should I play next time I'm playing. Next time I'm streaming, sorry. Sunday. I asked your opinion about Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I did the first two Tomb Raider games, a Tomb Raider, and what was the next one? That was the Icy World, right? I can't remember the other. Rise of the Tomb Raider. So I'm only missing Shadow of the Tomb Raider as the last part of the trilogy, the new trilogy. I'm not sure if it's going to be the fourth one. Never mind. Then I have Fallout 4. I've been considering that for a while. I have never played Fallout, so I don't really know any of the other stories and stuff. If that's necessary, I don't think so. What I've heard, it should be kind of like a standalone. So if you haven't played the other ones, it's okay. If you know the other ones, that gives you a little more depth, I think. But it should be like different vaults around the world. Around America, I don't know. Never mind. And then I have played XCOM 1. I've never been playing XCOM 2. I know it's a little older game, but I haven't been playing it, but that's my plan. And then The Ascent, it's a gift from a friend. I have played a little bit, like a couple of hours, maybe 4 hours or something, just to, you know, just see if it was a game I would enjoy playing, and I actually kind of enjoyed it. So, yeah. I was about to say what you want. Vote like you want. I want to say it's a little tip. If you're voting on your mobile phone and you're on your Wi-Fi, you can vote one time. And if you turn off the Wi-Fi and go on your mobile, you can vote again. It's kind of like IP locked, I think. And as Silent Dragon was kind enough to say, Sunday, if you have a VPN, you can vote as many times as you want. So if you have a game, don't do that. Just vote the 2 times. That would be okay. Otherwise, it would be you deciding what I'm playing, and that's not the idea. Kind of want the community to decide what we should play. But yeah. Right now, I think Shadow of the Tomb Raider is in front. Sharply followed by the Fallout 4. So yeah. check the poll out. Check my YouTube channel out. These streams will come on YouTube, but when eventually, just a little heads up. So right now, I'm trying to upload three of the Mass Effect 3 videos. I upload them an hour bits at the time, and I'm trying to upload so you can see the end of the stream if you missed this. So check that out. Also do other stuff, especially or only for YouTube. So check that out. Yeah, and I think the last thing I want to do is just wish you all a great day. Have fun gaming. Bye.